Mansoor Ahmed Usmani was a former Students Union president of the AMU. He was caught up in this controversy over the Jinnah portrait. The BJP went for him saying you are putting a Jinnah supporter. Not just in Jale where he's lost in a tough fight, well, relatively tough, but you can see across the region, this has had an effect on polarizing. In Mithilanchal, in Simanchal and in Kosi, an element of polarization did take place in the last phase of the elections. And that clearly could make the difference in the last run. This seat has had an impact on some of the surrounding seats as well, is what the Congress is now telling us.
No, not just here, up until Phulparas. Look, the whole politics here was a lot of Muslims, but also a lot of Yadavs and a lot of the underclass. But the Congress could have topped it up mythically with the Brahmin and the Dalit votes.
No, look,
that's
at,
not happened on the one side.
No, look at this
and you
seat.
Had a fracture in the other.
No, look at this seat, which is the seat you've been mentioning.
Abdul Bari Siddiqui. This is history.
Abdul Bari Siddiqui, multiple times winner, has lost in what is clearly very polarized election.
He's the most celebrated of the JP movement leaders.
That's
remember,
right.
I mean,
and one of the few who stayed with the RJD through good times and bad. So clearly what you've got is an element of polarization across Mithilanchal and Kosi and to some extent Simanchal as well. And that could cost the RJD-led Gathbandhan the election. The BJP was very successful in this area of playing the polarization card.
You know, if it had not been Usmani and if it had been, say, Prem Kumar, this polarization unfortunately is a fact of our political life now. You see it across states, across the country, it's happening. What is Usmani's crime? That he is a former president of the AMU Students Union. Is that a crime?
It was suggested that he had supported the entire idea of a portrait of Jinnah,
which is bogus because he is on record having written to the central government saying that his portrait should be removed. But because he was AMU president, AMU Students Union president, so had it not been Usmani, had it been Javed Ansari, they would have found something to pillar me.
And look, Razdeep, you know,
does this mean that now, candidates from the minority community should not be put up?
No, I didn't say that.
But the way this whole politics is being, we heard Mr. Amit Malviya say the last nail. Look at the kind of words being used.
I'm just telling you that an element of polarization has taken place. That's all I'm pointing out.
So had it not been Usmani, it would have been somebody.
In the areas where Nitish Kumar can do well, you see that there was no polarizing speeches by the Prime Minister or the BJP leaders. Come Simanchal, on November 3rd, the Prime Minister unleashes Bharat Mata ka naam lene se, Ram ka naam lene se, in logon ko parhez hai. I think there was a very structured attempt by the BJP and its, of course, the alliance partner in an area, Rajdeep, where the majority is, where the Hindus are known to behave like minorities.
Sandeep Shastri, you're with us. Do you believe that polarization could explain some of the part of this election, or is it more about fragmentation? The fact that the anti-Nitish vote by all indications has fragmented.
It's a combination, Rajdeep. Polarization at one level, fragmentation at another. Once the detailed results come in, I think what we are going to see is, especially in the third phase of election, you have seen polarization thanks to certain speeches made. You possibly have seen a consolidation of the Hindu vote. And at the other level, you have a fragmentation. I think the fact that the MIM is doing so well in certain seats, I think the Muslim vote has got fragmented. So I think for the Mahagathbandhan, we were talking of MY for the Mahagathbandhan. And even when we continue to talk of the MY, it will have to be a smaller M and a capital Y, because the full M does not seem to have gone with the Gathbandhan.
Look at the fragmentation, Rahul. 38% is the vote of the NDA, 37% RJD plus, LJP 6, but rock solid are others with 18.
No, but there the realization has to be that the Muslim community, especially in the Simanchal region, didn't have faith in the RJD plus candidates. If they did, you know, why are you blaming the BJP for what it did? The BJP played its card as best as it can, which is to rouse their vote bank and get them to vote. If, for example, the minorities in the constituencies where they dominate wanted to back the RJD, they could have. The fact that you've got the AIMIM winning on so many of them and helping the NDA win on the others suggest that the Muslims simply didn't have faith in the dual politics of the RJD and the Congress. That's the reality.
No, you are absolutely right. And look at those Simanchal numbers.
So why blame the BJP for that?
You know, let's look at Kishanganj.
All vote separately.
Let's look at Kishanganj, where clearly the Congress is leading at the moment and the AIM is trailing. But he's picking up 13,000 votes. Just take a look across the region. Let's take Katihar, for example. Here the BJP is leading. I'm trying to look for a constituency, a classic constituency here, where you will see the impact that the MIM is having.
Kishanganj, Bahadurganj.
All of them is here. You've got AIM, MIM, the what Rahul just said. 57,957 have voted while the RJD's got 32,834. So the Muslims.
So why blame the BJP?
Absolutely right. You're quite right. And why blame even Asauddin Owaisi? He says, I'm a politician. Want to expand.
I have a point here. Baisi is my research district. What you need to understand that these were the worst underdeveloped areas of the country. 15%.
So are we saying that the poorer Muslims prefer an OAC to the Congress?
The development card, not just the religion card. And OAC's speeches, if you go back and listen to it from the time of the last elections, he's talking of development plus. So the Muslim looking to something is not just a secular
very
card.
Quickly, very quickly, David.
Look, there's something more happening there, which is that one, people believe that RJD and Congress and these parties have not delivered no development. They also believe that Owaisi can, Owaisi speaks the language that they want to be heard against the BJP. That Owaisi can provide a more robust defense.
So that's not the BJP's fault.
No, and why should the BJP not do its politics? They can find a way.
I am not saying the BJP is at fault. Mr. Asaduddin Owaisi speaks the kind of robust militant language which they like. They believe that this Congress, a bit of this and a bit of namby-pamby stuff, they don't prefer.
Okay, at this moment, the NDA is in majority by just one seat. 123 versus 112, that's the latest figure. Let's go across straight to the Patna head office of the Bharatiya Janata Party state unit. Kumar Kunal joins us from there. Are they celebrating? Have they been told to hold the celebrations? What's happening on the ground at the BJP office?
Rahul, you can see how enthusiastic the workers are right now. They are celebrating already with drums, with all the kind of gulals. Everything can be seen on the face. And even the poetic things are coming out. अच्छा आपने कविता लिखी है क्या गाना गा रही थी आप जरा गा के बता दीजिए हमारे दर्शकों के लिए बीजेपी की जीत को लेकर
सुशासन के सरकार बा विकास के बयार बा आत्मनिर्भर बिहार बा गर्दा बा मोदी के हुंकार बा नीतीश से कुमार बा मोदी जी के जादू बा गर्दा बा
तो राहुल गर्दा बा इट इज बिहार में काबा देयर इज अ काउंटर नैरेटिव ऑफ बिहार में काबा एंड शी इज टेलिंग या प्लीज
स्ट्रेचर वेंटिलेटर एम्बुलेंस के भरमार हो स्ट्रेचर वेंटिलेटर एम्बुलेंस के भरमार हो और कहे के साफ करेला मोर चश्मा के पावर हो गर्दा
सो यू कैन सी दैट हाउ दीज वर्कर्स आर सेलिब्रेटिंग ऑल्दो स्टिल द काउंटिंग प्रोसेस इज गोइंग ऑन इट इज नॉट कंप्लीटेड बट they are celebrating all over with drums, with all the power, whatever they are requiring, they are going through. Jai Shri Ram ka naam.
Tejaswi pucha karte the, Bihar mein kaba. Ye to janta ne bata diya ki Bihar mein kaba, aur main batata hu ki RJD mein kaba. Ego, RJD mein kaba, ego Lalu ji.
Lekin ab to
Urachi jail.
अब तो नीतीश जी का कम सीट आया है बीजेपी को ज्यादा सीट आया है तो आपको लगता है क्या कि अब आपके सीएम बनना चाहिए
देखिए जो वादा किया है वो निभाएंगे ये भारतीय जनता पार्टी है हमें वादे से मुकरना नहीं आता जो हमारे राष्ट्रीय और शीर्ष नेतृत्व ने तय कर दिया है हम उसे ही मानेंगे
बीजेपी
that if the majority will be won by NDA, then Nitish Kumar will be the face of the government. And they are saying that once they have committed that Nitish Kumar will be the chief minister, they will not go back on their word. The celebration is all around. Poems are going on. Drums are beating.
What we know is Bihar tight ba. That's the contest is very tight ba. There is no doubt about it. 121 versus 114. This is the first time that the NDA in many hours has come one seat below the majority mark. I want to show you that margin calculator that everyone's asking about and show you what the margin calculator says. At this moment, there are 14 seats in Bihar. 14 seats where the gap between the party that's leading and the party that's coming in at number two is less than 500 votes. These seats are Bakhri, Bad, Badhara, Begusarai, Dinara, Madhepura, Ramgarh, Sultanganj, Tarapur, it goes on. Eight of those leads for the NDA, six of the RJD. No one can predict on these seats what will happen. Eight of those leads for the NDA, five for the BJP, three for the JDU. From the RJD plus, five of those leads for the RJD, one for the Congress. These are leads of a margin of less than 500. 31 leads at this moment with a margin of less than 1,000. These two could change. 14 of them for the NDA. And they could change in any direction. Listen, if there's anyone who tells you that he knows which way these leads will solidify, I can guarantee to you he's talking through his hat. Because when it's down to margins as tight as that, if you're a pundit, you just sit back and do commentary. If you are a politician or a supporter, this is where you bring out the beads. If you are just having fun when you watch this election, get your chai pakoda and evening chai. Because this is a tight election. There can be no dispute about that. 14 leads for the NDA in seats where the gap is less than 1,000. 17 for the RJD alliance. And out of those, the RJD itself on 11, the Congress on 4, the CPIML on 1, the CPI on 1. This is going down to the wire. But remember, Rajat Sethi, if this is the way it ends, then the NDA has the advantage because they... Let's look at the routes to power. And this will give you a sense of what could happen next. Because if you look, if you compare, and if they're close to 120, they'll find some way. You've got some way of being able to get to 122. Would you agree with that?
Oh, yes, certainly. I think BSP will find it very hard to go with the Congress having had very bad experiences in Rajasthan, their MLAs being poached. So there'll be a lot of people who would want to reach out to these eight others who are currently in the fray and ensure that all of them stay put and do not switch sides.
One lead came down. It was 121. It's down to 120 versus 115. Is it getting tighter? Manisha Priyam?
It is, but the fact is that there are a lot of BJP candidates fighting on LJP tickets, and I've always believed that at the end, it is they who will have a very important role to form an NDA government.
No, but there is no LJP lead. It doesn't matter if you're not leading. If you're leading on zero, it doesn't matter how many candidates are fighting.
They will have it tight.
Chirag Paswan,
then
if he was on the side of the NDA, would have ensured that by now we were watching the IPL, the real one.
Chirag
Paswan is like a human bomb, you know. Hum to dubenge sanam, tumko bhi le dubenge.
Hum to dub gaye sanam, and this is tumhar ko phasa ke chale gaye.
This is lottery time for eight others. You know, this is their dream come true scenario.
No, but the thing
if
about
this,
the eight
if
others,
this remains,
I look at that as they
becomes tighter.
I'll show you who the eight others are. Five of them are AIMIM. Now, I don't see Javed can
that.
Come in. AIMIM cannot go on the... Whatever they do or don't do, they can't support the BJP.
Yeah,
I mean, officially they can't support the BJP. Behind the scenes, whatever else they may do is a different matter. They can abstain, but they can't support the BJP. Then you've got one BSP. One BSP can certainly support the BJP. You've got two others. They can also support the NDA. So you've got three.
It all depends. If the NDA is single largest, they will be called, and if they get the first call at government formation, then I am willing to bet my last penny that they will form the government. They
how?
Will successfully
by breaking
form.
The Congress? How?
Do whatever. By breaking...
What will
breaking
say? Let's assume we end
whatever.
Up in a situation, and since we're just looking at it from a hypothetical perspective, if Owaisi Javed is in a position where he gets to play kingmaker with his five leads, what will he do?
He'll set conditions for support.
No, but he can't go to the BJP.
No, he won't go to the BJP. He'll set such conditions to for RJD. Make life very difficult or
okay. For conditions for the RJD.
I want to show you. No, this is getting exciting. BJP, which is where the election the intelligence unit's dashboard comes into play. Let's look at the routes to power. When we were working on this graphic, you know, I told the producers that I don't know whether we'll ultimately get to use it, but who knows, we may be able to use it, because at this moment you've got 122 leads for the NDA, 114 for the RJD. You've got 4 AIMIM supporters. If they go to the BJP, BJP is at 126, but I don't see how AIMIM can go to the BJP. So you have to put the AIMIM on this side. Now, whatever negotiation happens, etc., is a different matter. But that makes it 122 versus 118. Now you've got two others and one BSP. Behenji supported the BJP in the Rajya Sabha polls in Uttar Pradesh, so you can safely put that one candidate here. These two others, I'd assume, because of the BJP's strength in getting the others on their side, you could put them here. But these three others will also pull their weight and earn a lot of money possibly. But you have to put them over here, because that's the party with the greater strength of being able to get them. We're down to 119 versus this television punditry is very dangerous. Because the amount of verbal somersaults you have to do as things go by, this route to power needs to be reworked. So you've got 119 versus 115, others now at 9. I just want to reboot the election intelligence dashboard. Things are getting as exciting can be. In the margin calculator, at this moment, there are 16 seats with a gap of less than 500 votes. 16 such seats. Which means every time there is a new round of counting, it could switch this way or that. If you're a candidate or a supporter of the NDA or the RJD alliance, you know, you'd be chewing your nails off at this moment. 16 leads, less than 500, 9 to the NDA. Out of which 5 are for the BJP, 4 are for the JDU, RJD plus leading in 7 seats, 5 for the RJD, 1 for the Congress, 1 for the CPI. This Manisha Priyam is going down to the wire.
Yes, it's extremely close, and at this point of time, it does not seem clear as to who would be supporting the RJD plus, that is the Mahagathbandhan. Would it be coming close to power? Possibly only the AIMIM. But even that doesn't bring it any close to 5 of their seats, still bring it only to 119. So AIMIM plus the others, that could be the RJD's route. Whereas for the NDA, you could still have the others and BSP. Is that the route? So it still seems like a cliffhanger, even if you account for an even distribution of the seats that are left.
We might see extended days of resort politics again. Yeah. Bihar incidentally has no resorts.
All these pundits were saying the Indian process is so fast. It gets over in 5 hours. Nevada versus Nevada. The ball is reverse swinging on the pitch of Patna at this moment.
Third phase ka election le gaya.
Bihar unfortunately doesn't have resorts. So they'll have to find another state where they can ferry all these MLAs, newly minted MLAs.
UP on this side, Bengal on that side.
Nepal.
They'll take MLAs to Nepal.
Kya paddle chala jao to Nepal.
I think eventually Jharkhand.
Okay, can I show you now the other big battles? Now, make no mistake, if they don't say so publicly, it doesn't matter. But there is a high prestige battle on at this moment between the Bharatiya Janata Party and the RJD over who gets to be the single largest party. Just at this moment, you've got the RJD at 76, the BJP at 73. Through the large part of the day, the BJP has been the number one party. At this moment, the RJD is 3 ahead. And that is significant, because that will be like a prestige battle about who gets to, you know, go back and say, I'm single largest. There's a lot of political significance to that. Let's go down and show you what's happening in the face-to-face. I call this the tug-of-war graphic. In the direct fights between the BJP and the RJD, the BJP is leading on 39. Now, this is important, because this is what prestige is all about. Rajat Sethi, prestige is all about this battle. When the BJP took on the RJD, if these are the two most powerful parties in the battle, BJP with a 66% strike rate, leading on 39 of them, the RJD leading only on 20 with a 34% strike rate in the key prestige battle.
So this implies that the strike rate of the JDU has further plummeted since we last discussed. So again, the weaker link on the NDA side is clearly JDU, and the weaker link on the other side, Mahagathbandhan, is Congress Party.
No,
so
I can
both
show
of these people have been pulling down.
Whereas if you look at the RJD versus JDU, here the RJD is...
Yeah, so they were at 44% earlier in the day.
72% strike rate against the JDU. So they are punching the JDU very hard, but they're getting punched by the BJP. So it's a verdict where what result you are likely to get depends on who you're fighting. I'm taking a break. This is getting exciting. 121 versus 1114 with five AIMIM candidates unlikely to support the NDA. So that's 119 versus 121. Battle for who gets to be number one. No one crossing the 122 figure, but the NDA very, very close. We will take this down right to the wire, give you a sense of what's happening in every single seat, break up this election like absolutely no one else will. When we come back on the other side of a very quick break, you're watching a live and continuing coverage of Result Day in Bihar.